What is good, everybody? My name is Gino Diaz, signing in, and welcome to my channel. So today, I would like to give a huge shout out to my friend Jewel. He sponsored me this, or he gave me this specific part that I've been looking for. So today, I'm actually gonna be working on it, and I'll quickly show you guys.
So it's the OEM Infiniti G35 coupe, OEM factory mod guards or mod flaps basically, and these are very rare nowadays, and you can't really buy them from factory, as you know, they discontinued. They usually comes in the higher models. So yeah, this came from obviously another G35 coupe that is in black. So what I'm gonna do today, I'm actually gonna be trying to paint match it to my car right there. As you can see, that's my Infiniti G35 coupe. Obviously it's not gonna be perfect, but obviously I have to prepare it. I kind of washed it already. I might just have to give it a little bit of quick wash once again, but basically all you need to do first is get a 400 grit sandpaper. Basically what we're gonna do is wet sand it from it. Basically I would do is sand it twice, so I'm gonna finish one layer of wet sanding it and let it dry, then try it, then do it again, and then after that we're gonna go for the adhesion promoter. Good. I cut the 400 grit papers or sandpaper into four, so I'm gonna have to be using two of them on each mod guard. So let's do it. Alright guys, so I'm sanding it right now with 400 grit, as you guys can see. I mean, I don't really have a table or anything here, but I use this area, it's flat, and just comparing it to the other one. The glossy is gone from this. I'm gonna be keeping on doing this, and then I'm gonna start doing the other one as well. It's hard for me to do it with one hand, but it's much easier to do two hands, but you know, with my phone or camera filming, you see the point, right?
I'm currently here in one of the washrooms in our backyard, but as you guys can see, it's starting to drying up now. I'm gonna do another sanding, right? As you guys can see, the gloss is gone. Looks pretty good, and it works from what I wanted it to be. So if you want to sand it, it should be looking like this. This is what you want it to look like. So it was from gloss to this. Okay, I'm just gonna wait to dry it up and then do another sanding. So another 400 grit right here. Let's get to work. I really have to do it with two hands, but I'm gonna quickly show you. Basically just want to go quickly straight, sorry about the noise, just straight, to be honest I really have to hold it, but yeah, just an update. Wet sanding it on two layers of 400 grit wet sanding right here. As you can see, it's slowly drying off, then it's going to be ready for adhesion promoter. Looks really good, and after that we're going to go for primer. I just finished applicating the spraying the adhesion promoter, two layers each. I didn't really get to film the whole thing, obviously I have to focus. So this is how it looks right now. It looks like basically matte black, which is really nice. I really like how it looks. So it's basically ready for primer soon, so I'm just letting it dry it up, and I might go for primer, I'm not sure. So yeah,
all right guys, so it's ready. So the primer that I'm gonna be using is the white primer from Rust-Oleum Painters Touch. I got it from Canadian Tire. You can either get it from Walmart or somewhere else, but this is what I'm gonna be using. The mod guards are ready for it,
So I'm gonna be using it. Hopefully it's not gonna be too crazy, and hopefully I won't mess it up. But this is the hardest part as well, as they tend to have runs if you put too much. All right, here we go. Here goes nothing. Hey, what is good, everyone? It's actually the next day already, and I ran out of time last night, so I'm gonna be having to continue today. So I'll show you the progress. This is how it looks like right now. It's basically done. I didn't get to film with the primer. This is done with the primer as well as with the base coat. Obviously it's not perfect. It's gonna be like that. It looks really good so far. Now the next thing that I'm gonna be doing is using the clear coat. I'm gonna be using another Ultra Covert 2x from Rust-Oleum. It's a semi-gloss clear, so I'm gonna be using it for this too. Guys, here's the final product. Looks really good and glossy. So next step is I'm gonna be trying to install it on my car without taking off the rear wheels. So other than that, thank you so much for watching. I'm gonna try to install this once again and show you the results. And yep, I hope you enjoyed the video. Really like how it turned out. Thank you so much for watching. Feel free to subscribe. Thank you. So this is my car, as you can see. I'm gonna try to attempt to install the mud guard here without taking off the rear wheels. I don't have tools or jack here. I always have to go to my friend to get it done. But anyways, I just started cleaning. This used to be super dirty with tire marks from doing so much sliding or donuts. I don't do burnouts. I have to take some wires off, but in that matter, I just have to use some dish soap, water, and a spray bottle. So it's a bit clean now, but I'm gonna show you. So I'm gonna start cleaning it from here. As you can see, there's some green bubbles or soap going on. So I'm gonna wipe it down. Alright, so now I'm gonna be doing on the other side as well. Just spray just to clean it real quick. Wipe it down. Actually, this time I'm gonna be using the other side. As you can see, it's pretty dirty. I just recently went to a car wash, and basically recently just washed this car. Now it's dirty again. Kinda annoying. Alright guys, so here's what we need. So obviously I'm gonna need some type of driller. I already have the dish soap used and cleaned the fender, and it's good to go. Obviously I have some screws that I'm gonna be using. I already chose them specifically just in case, different sizes, but most likely I'm only gonna need 4 of them. Obviously I have this one as well. For this one specifically, and I have some specific driller size that I'll be using in a bit, and I'm just waiting for the mud guards to dry off from the clear coat, and we should be good to go. Also, I forgot to mention, you're also gonna be needing a double-sided tape. This is one of the heavy-duty ones, the Gorilla tape, that you're gonna be using to put on the mud guards. It is ready to go. Looks really nice in my own opinion. With the sunlight this time, looks really good, shining as well. Sheesh. Alright guys, it's done. The mud guards is officially installed. As you can see, it's obviously not perfect. If you guys I'm obviously not a professional on paint matching, and this is like close to impossible to paint match because you need a lot of separate or different paint match to obviously make this one look perfectly the same. But I'm very happy on how it looks. OEM Plus, I'm gonna give it some time. Hopefully it's gonna turn to cream-ish white, but I hope you like the video anyways. This is how it looks. I'm also gonna be doing the other one next, but this is how it looks. Thank you so much for watching. Once again, thank you so much for watching. Obviously it's not perfect. I hope I didn't disappoint you, but from this angle it looks really good, right? But if you look closer, it's obviously not the same paint, and which is understandable because I'm not a professional. It's all like DIY, and I got it from a friend, and it's free. So if you like this video, feel free to subscribe, you know, feel free to follow me. It's a project for a reason. Thank you so much for watching. Feel free to subscribe once again. My name is Gino Diaz, signing out. Peace.